Today on Channel 9000 News, we are featuring two special stories. We will be discussing physicist George Robert Carruthers, and later, we will discuss the 1965 Voting Rights Act. George Robert Carruthers was born on October 1, 1939 in Cincinnati, Ohio. At the age of 10, he built his first telescope using lenses and cardboard tubes. When he was 12 years old, his father died, and so his family moved to Chicago, where his mother was from originally. Carruthers was one of the few African Americans competing in high school science fairs in Chicago, and he won 3 awards for his projects. In 1961, Carruthers earned his bachelor's degree in physics at the University of Illinois. He continued studying at the University of Illinois to earn his master's in nuclear engineering in 1962, and his PhD in aeronautical and astronautical engineering in 1964. After earning his PhD, he went on to work at the U.S. Naval Research Facility. 2 years later, 1966, he worked as a full-time research physicist at the U.S. Naval Research Facility's E.O. Hilbert Center for Space Research. Carruthers worked with NASA, using his inventions to capture various UV, which is short for ultraviolet, images of planets, stars, galaxies, and more. He also invented the image converter, which detects certain types of radiation and short wavelengths. During one of NASA's missions in the 1970s, Carruthers' spectrograph proved the existence of molecular hydrogen in outer space. Also, during the Apollo 16 mission, which was a manned mission to explore the moon, his spectrograph captured images of over 500 nebulae, galaxies, and stars. When Halley's Comet last passed by Earth in 1980, his spectrograph captured an ultraviolet image of it. Not only was Carruthers dedicated to research, but he was also dedicated to education as well. He created the Science and Engineers Apprentice Program, which allowed high school students to spend the summer at the U.S. Naval Research Facility. In 1996 and 1997, Carruthers taught an Earth and Space Science course for public schools in Washington, D.C. In the year 2002, Carruthers began to teach a course in Earth and Space Science at Howard University. To this day, Carruthers remains one of the most influential African American scientists in U.S. history. Now, before we discuss the Voting Rights Act of 1965, let's go over some background information on the 15th Amendment. Ratified in 1870, the 15th Amendment gave the former slaves the right to vote. Along with the 14th Amendment, the 15th Amendment, it protected the rights of former slaves, including making interference with voting rights a federal crime. The 1965 Voting Rights Act closely followed the 15th Amendment. The act was created after President Lyndon B. Johnson called for the voting rights of African Americans to be protected. It was signed in on August 6, 1965, and it denied the government any ability to discriminate voting rights based on race or color. Many of the tricks that some state and or local governments were using to deny voting rights included grandfather clauses, literacy tests, poll taxes, and whites-only primaries. Not only did the act increase the number of African-American voters, but it also encouraged more elected African-American officials. In 1970, the act was expanded on in order to protect the rights of non-native English speakers. Every so often, the act has to be extended. It was extended for another 5 years in 1970, 7 years in 1975, and 25 years in 1982. It was extended fairly recently in 2006 for another 25 years. will update on this story again whenever it is re-signed in the future around the year 2031. We have run out of time for the evening, and we will now pass it on to Bob with the local weather.